is not the shepherd, who own the sheep or not. Seeth the wolf coming and leaving the sheep. How many of you know this sister here is a true shepherd? I fight for anybody up in this place.
Amen. I know.
Dear Ron Nelson, I stand right there and fight for the sheep because I believe in you and I believe that's what God called me for.
Amen.
Stand right there, protect, cover them with the blood of Jesus. I'm not a hireling. You can, I'm not hired to preach. I am called to preach.
Yeah.
Come on. And come on. You got a lot of hiring out here. And that all they in for it is for the money.
Yeah.
I am called to preach by God, chosen by God to carry this gospel of Jesus Christ. And I got to preach the word of God.
Yeah.
So you can't buy me. Only thing that I buy by is this word.
Yeah.
Whatever the word of God says. I got to say what the word says.
Amen.
That's what it is.
Yeah.
Listen, give me 1 minute. And Jesus said this. He said, the hireling fleeth because he is a hireling and careth not for the sheep. I care for every last one of the sheep
Amen.
That God has given me. And I believe that.
Yes.
Amen. He said, and Jesus said, I am the good shepherd and know my sheep. And am known of mine. In other words, they know me. They know who I am. As the Father knoweth me, this is what Jesus said, even so know I the Father. I lay down my life for the sheep.
Amen.
That's what he said. Other sheep I have which are not of this fold. Them also I must bring. This is my passion. This is my goal. This is my objective. This is my desire, that what I want to do, I must bring, and they shall hear my voice.
Yes.
And there shall be one fold and one shepherd. Yes. Therefore doeth my Father love me, because I lay down my life that I might take it again. No man taketh it from me, Jesus said. Jesus volunteered and he laid it down. He said this. He said, therefore does my Father love me, because I lay down my life, listen, that I might take it again. No man taking it from me, I lay it down of myself. I have power to lay it down, and I have power to take it again. This commandment have I received of my Father. People, I want you to know that there is not one door that you can get to heaven.
Amen.
And that door is Jesus Christ.
Amen.
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 And constantly on there is power in the name of Jesus. And I'm going to ask each and every one of you, if you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, let me tell you this story before. When I was at my house, this boy by the name of Keontae, 22 years old, he was sitting there on the step, and I said, Keontae, I started talking to him about Jesus. Tell him, I said, have you ever given your life to Christ? He said, well, I did, and when I was a child. And he said, but I kind of like don't believe that, believing. And he said, I don't know. I said, you know what? I said, I'm praying for you. And I'm going to ask God to show you who he is. And I prayed for that young man. And I prayed for him. And he was just shaking my head. And he said, if you know, when I pray for people, they feel me. They call it energy, but it's a spirit. And that boy, about a week or two later, got killed by one of his friends. Celebrated his 22nd birthday down at Motel 6 with all of his friends. His friend, one of the friends, disrespected a girl. He told him he was going to have to leave. And when he walked in on the outside, that boy stabbed him right in his foot. He stumbled back inside of the house instead of his friends putting their hands in that hole and holding it there until the ambulance got there. All of them ran. And you talking about a friend? Bible said, Jesus said, I am a friend that stick closer
Amen.
Than any brother.
Amen.
that brought. I was so mad with some of the rest of them, and I told them, I said, you need to tell me, y'all call yourself friend. I would have put my hand right there on his womb and told them to call the police. But the girls, that the other girl that left, she said, I would have did the same thing. She said, but I left early. People know Jesus as your Lord and Savior. If you're not saved and you've never accepted him into your life, listen, hear the call. Turn it up, Constant. Hear the call God is saying to you. Come unto me. All I'm asking you to do, all you got to do is say, Lord, look, I don't know everything about you, but I accept you as my Lord and Savior. Come into my life. Save me, God. I don't know everything about it, but help me. I want anybody that you feel that you need to get down here, come and stand right down here.